根本的成上师及方三世一切诸佛，嗡阿吽观相顶。
Homage to our lineage guru and the teachers of the altar. Now we are inviting the primary supplicants for this homa to come forward and present the offering of Hatha to the lineage root guru as a symbol of the highest honor.
让我们以热烈的掌声感谢师尊的加持。
Inviting His Holiness to bless the offering items at the gift shop. We are truly grateful to our Lineage Root Guru for his blessings. Now we are inviting His Holiness to take the Homa throne. And we are inviting Simu, Wajra Master Lian Xiang, and all the Dharma Masters reference. Our distinguished guests and all the participants to please take the seats. First, let's give a round of applause to show our utmost gratitude to our Lineage Root Guru for presiding over this White Tara Homa Fire Offering Ceremony. We would also like to extend a warm welcome to all participating Masters, Reference, and all participants from all over the world. Thank you for coming and your support in the ceremony. The White Tara Ceremony has now begun. Clap twice and snap your fingers as a wake-up call. Visualize Dhruvada lineage. Namo Vairukana Buddha. Namo Buddha Lokana. Namo Amitabha Buddha. Namo Padma Kumara. Namo Lianfeng Buddha Lian Sheng. Visualize Grandmaster and all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas radiating light to bless us. Recite the Guru Mantra 7 times. Recite purification mantras and the Earth Deity mantra. This is an invocation mantra. We sincerely invoke our lineage root guru, Maha White Padma Kumara, His Holiness Living Buddha Lianshan. Our lineage root guru, the Maha White Padma Kumara, His Holiness Living Buddha Lianshan. Our lineage root guru, the Maha White Padma Kumara, His Holiness Living Buddha Lianshan. We sincerely invoke the main deity of Homa, Namo Vaitara. The main deity of Homa, Namo Vaitara. The main deity of Homa, Namo Vaitara. We sincerely invoke Namo Yamantaka Akala, the four heavenly kings, golden mother of the primordial Jetpan, Sima Bodhisattva, Rainbow Temples, all Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis, and divinities, true Buddha tantric orders, deities, all the deities enshrined at the Seattle Temple, at the abode at the Southern Mountain, and the true Buddha Seattle Chapter. Rainbow temples, mountain god, earth god, plant god, wind god, water god, heavenly fire god, dragon gods, all divinities as well as the city god, to please radiate light and bless this Homa. Perform great procession using visualization for Student Guru and all Buddhas. Visualize for procession on the ground. Release Samudra. Second to all Bodhisattvas. Visualize for procession on the ground. Release Samudra. Third to all Herukas and Dhamma protectors. Visualize for procession on the ground. Release Samudra. Fourth head bow. Great mandala offering. Form the offering mudra. Visualize the transformations of the offerings to transform, to become innumerable and fill the whole universe. Make the offering above to the lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, the main deity of Homa, the White Tara, all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, in the middle to all Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis and divinities, and below to all sentient beings. Mount Meru, four continents and sun and moon transform into pieces offerings for the Buddhas. May these wondrous treasures and merits spread our karma to all of our civilization. For food refuge, visualize our lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, Buddha jewel, Dhamma jewel, and Sangha jewel to form bright white light to empower us. Form Vajra Club Mudra. Recite Vajrapani Mantra 7 times. Inviting His Holiness to perform blessings with Mala. inviting His Holiness to set ceremonial demarcation, to bless the registration forms and all the offerings. Inviting His Holiness to perform the ritual of opening the fire pit and set ceremonial demarcation around it. Inviting His Holiness to lit the Homa fire, to make all the offerings and to perform mudra transformations for purifications, enhancements, magnetization, subjugation and bardo deliverance. We will be chanting the heart mantra of the main deity today, the White Tara. And during this time, you may also perform the Homa visualization, the emergence of the deity, the merging of the deity with the Homa fire, and the merging with you into the Homa fire. Then visualize the Homa fire burn away all karma and negativities.
Thank you.
Recite the mantras of the eight principal deities in Ken Buddha Amitabha. All uphold the Buddhas, ascend to the realm of utmost bliss, repaying fourfold generosities from above, aiding those in the three realms below. Upon seeing the Buddha, may we transcend life and death like the Buddha, may we liberate me. We, your disciples, dedicate the merit of the ceremony to our lineage root guru. May you stay healthy, live a long life with great self-mastery, continually stay in samsara to turn the Dharma wheel. Inviting stillness to perform the overall merit dedication. Wholeheartedly, we pay homage to Om Petja Guruya Soha. Wholeheartedly, we pay homage to Om Petja Guruya Soha. We pray to the Seven-Eyed Buddha Mother to guide all the Bhartu spirits to be reborn into the auspicious copper color mountain Pure Land. We pray to the Seven-Eyed Buddha Mother to guide the Bhartu spirits to be reborn into the auspicious Danya Katanya Pure Land. We pray to the Seven-Eyed Buddha Mother to guide all the Bhartu spirits to be reborn into the double twin lotus ponds of the Maha Western Paradise. By your ambrosia, please bless all participants with good health, longevity, and self-mastery. May all illnesses be alleviated. We pray to the Seven-Eyed Buddha Mother to open your seven eyes to observe upon all sentient beings, to shine bright radiance so that all karma can be eradicated. The Mara of affliction, Mara of death, Mara of the five aggregates, and the heavenly Mara. By the utmost brilliance, they vanish. May we be endowed with ample resources and perfect wisdom. May we not create any causes and attain fruition. May we live in harmony with love and respect. May we benefit from our spiritual cultivation. May our fruition improve. May Buddha lands be beautified and strong and robust. Of the heavens, gods of the earth, may we be far from all calamities, may all calamities abandon us, let all disasters turn into dust, may all enemies and enmities vanish. We say 100 syllable mantra 3 times. Using visualization, first the root guru and all Buddhas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, Lili Samudra, second to all Bodhisattvas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, Lili Samudra, third to all Herukats and Dhamma protectors. Visualize for prostration on the ground, Lili Samudra, fourth Hepa. Recite completion mantra. Now please stand up and together let's join our palms with great reverence, and together we are inviting His Holiness to take the Dharma teaching seat. Give a round of applause to show our utmost gratitude to His Holiness. for presiding over this precious Homa fire offering ceremony. And now let's join our palms together. We're inviting His Holiness to bestow the precious Buddha Dharma. First, let's pay homage to the lineage gurus. Homage to the Venerable Meng Liaoming. Homage to Master Sakya Tsongkhong. Homage to His Holiness the 16th Karmapa. And homage to Master Dubten Tarchi. Homage to the three jewels of the altar. And homage to the main deity of Homa today. Masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma instructors, Dharma assistants, directors of temples and chapters, and disciples over here as well as on the webcast. Our VIPs today are the Madam to Ambassador Daniel Liao, the Taipei rep to Sweden, Dharma Sister Judy. And after this ceremony, she will go to Sweden and come back for the grand ceremony. And a member of the Two Buddha School Scholars and Professors Group, Professor Liang Caofan, producers for the Gyeni Diansang Sinten from CTITV Taiwan, Dharma Sister Rebecca Xiaqi, and Dr. Su Lin, Dr. Ryan Zhuang, and Mrs. Zhuang, accountant to Two Buddha School, Dharma Sister Teresa, and husband. And rep to the Council of Taipei City, Dharma Sister Chie Hui Ling, a daughter of the former Council of Kaohsiung City, Dharma Sister Wu Mingxian, good afternoon, everybody. How do you do? Like to make an announcement. Next Sunday, August 20th, Sunday at 3 p.m., there will be the Homa for Akasagarbha Bodhisattva. Akasagarbha. He is also referred as the Kusang Vajra. Kobudaisi's Yidam is Akasagarbha Bodhisattva, although his Yidam was also Vairocana Buddha. But he often practiced Akasagarbha Bodhisattva. And Akasagarbha's pure land is in the stars. When you attain fruition in his Akasagarbha practice, he saw a star descended from the sky and entered into his mouth. And from then on, he was endowed with the very superior wisdom. And because of this high, the great wisdom of Akasakarba, he did not have any memory problems. He remembers everything. So that's why there was a practice, which is the Akasakarba's memorizing all that is heard. So you will always remember what you have heard. You will never forget them. So this is the Dharma practice of Akasakarba. Next Sunday is this deity. And today we practice the white Tara and the mantra. This is also referred as the seven eye Buddha Mother. The third eye, one, two eyes, and then two eyes in the middle of her palms, and two eyes at her soles, altogether seven eyes. So she's called Seven Eye Buddha Mother, and she's white. And the mudra is the same. The mudra of all Dakinis, the same. The same mudra. In order to invoke her, the middle fingers of the mudra rub against each other three times. This is the key formula. In order to touch White Tara's heart, and then she descends, and then she would descend. By rubbing three times, she naturally descends. That's to touch her heart. So in mudras, there are lots of this tips and tricks. So when you rub the middle fingers three times, the Yidam, the main deity, will descend upon you into your body. White Tara, I transmitted in Hsinchu, Taiwan, at the Fuyu Leizang Temple. So you visualize her to descend on top of your head, and she's seated on a white lotus throne. And with the root, the stalk of the blossom that would enter through the tip of your head, through the central channel, and you recite her mantra in your meditation and form her mudra. And from this blossom stalk, there would be white nectar dripped into your body. And you let it flow to any parts of your body that's ailing. And eventually you're filled with the nectar that's emitted by White Tara. And all the black karma would be expelled through the skin pores and the bottom of your feet. So all the black karma is emitted and your body becomes clean, clear, and purified, all white, filled with nectar. Then you would attain longevity, self-mastery, and health, and all illnesses will be eradicated. This is the White Tara Longevity Dharma practice. By practicing it, you would gain good health, longevity, self-mastery, and purity. And all of your karma will be eradicated. The white lotus moves to the top of your head. The white Tara is on top of the lotus. And the blossom stalk would be connected to your central channel, and drops by drops, the white nectar will enter and fill your body, so that all your organs will be moistened and refreshed by the white nectar, and the black karma will be expelled from your body, and you become purified. This is the purification Dharma practice. Like when you come for repurification, it will be good if you practice this Dharma. And it can eliminate all the bad karma from the past. The key of eradicating all your karma is never to create any more karma in this lifetime. And the karma from past lives, by the blessings of the Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and the Root Guru, can be expelled through from your body, and gradually you would attain purity. Once you're purified, then you can attain the four sagely realms: Arhat, Pratika Buddha, Bodhisattva, and Buddha. Those were the four sages. And most importantly is you want to make it purified. And you don't create any more karma now. And the karma from the past in your Dharma practice are being annihilated. That's in Tantrayana. You transform the three karma of body, speech, and mind into three secrets. So the three karma of the body, speech, and mind are transformed into become three secrets. And the three secrets are the mudra, which is the secret of the body, and the secret of the speech is mantra chanting, and the secret of the mind is visualization. So spiritual cultivation is also called the practice of visualization. You visualize the image of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. You visualize her seven eyes of the seven eye Buddha mother and recite her mantra, Om Becca Guru Ya Soha, and form her mudra. And you let the white nectar to enter into your body and to eradicate your black karma. This is the White Tara Dharma. It's extremely important. In order to invoke her to descend, you have to rub your middle fingers three times. That's to touch White Tara's heart. This deity is extremely great because she's one of the three longevity deities, which refer to Buddha of longevity, Amitayus, Ushnisha Vijaya, and White Tara. So by practicing any of these three deities, you would attain, you would gain longevity. Okay, Master is 73 this year. I cannot say words through the grapevine again, because it's kind of like a little bit like a hang up in my heart, because X said that I will die at 73, and she's been talking about it for 8 years, like a little knot in my heart, that X was my ex-disciple, and perhaps she cared for me. That's why she kept saying that I would die at 73. At first I thought living to be 60 years is good enough. And I have had 13 extra years already. I'm becoming impatient. And yet she said that I will die at 73, and I am 73 this year. So my disciple cared too much, kept talking about my death at 73. Was it good or not good? Or neutral? So you ponder on it yourself. If someone kept talking about her teacher or guru to die at 73, would she be a good disciple? No. In that case, I have to live past 73. I have to live past 73. It's very rare to see this kind of disciple. I have taken refuge in over 20 gurus, frankly speaking. In this life, I have cultivated for over 40 years, and I have paid homage to 27 gurus, gurus from Tantrayana and Mahayana, and the precept gurus. There were three of them. And from Tian De Seng Cao Jiao the Xiao Changming, father and son, they were also my refuge gurus, and many other masters like Master Pu Fang, Master Pu Yi, Master Pu Quan were all gurus that I took refuge in. I have so many gurus. It took me a while to sort them out. When I see a good guru, I would immediately kneel down, paid homage, and took refuge. I was really craving or thirsty for good gurus. So, but I highly respect each of my gurus. Although I can do divination, I never perform any divination on my guru's age. That's a taboo. In respecting your gurus, how can you say at what age the guru will die? That's not right. Nobody else ever said what age I will die. I have asked Golden Mother, at what age will I die? And Golden Mother never told me. Golden Mother never told me. And she said, I will let you know when you're about to die. How? I would, that at that time, I would be dying. And she said that at first I would show a celestial, like a hat or crown, a red one, would descend from heaven, and then with a piece of cloth, red cloth with black writing, and you will die on what time, date, month, and year. She said that she will let me know, then you would know when you see the celestial hat. That's what the Golden Mother told me. And now at 73, I kept looking for it. When will it descend? And I haven't seen it until now. So it showed that I will not die this year. So talking about longevity, in terms of life value, so if you feel that you have power in your spiritual cultivation already, then you can go back. That's how it is. Because you have gained the values of your life, you have power in your spiritual cultivation, then you can go back to the Pure Land. You can return to your original position or place. Then you can have attainment. Then there will be no regrets. So in this life, I have no regrets. Even if I die now, there's no regret. No regrets. It's worth it. That's the key point for us spiritual cultivators. It's worth it. In your value systems, it's worth it. That you already have the values, you can go back. So I don't care at what age I return, that I have to live to be 80s or 90s or 100. No need, no particular. I hope that I would just die in my sleep. That's the best way to die. Not in the hospital. My mom often told me, do you understand? You don't want to drag your and fill with tubes in the hospital. No dignity whatsoever. And when disciples come to visit, I feel almost like a mummy. That's really meaningless. Then they have to take care of your poop and pee and all that. That would be horrible. So if you can die in your sleep, that's really number one. Then that's worth it. It has values. And words through the grapevine. Oh, again. Sorry. There is a disciple from San Francisco who asked, August 2016 was the grand ceremony of Mahabala. At that time, X said, she was going to have her soul traveling out of body to return to the Mahatwin lotus ponds. And she did not want to come back. And the primary reason was because the samsara was too dirty and too foul. So she wanted to leave her body. And she said it herself that in the grand ceremony of 2016, Mahabala descended and used his feet to cover the tip of her crown so that she could not leave her body. And Mahabala told her that her duty has not ended. So a disciple wrote a note and asked me if this story was truthful. My answer is, if you know that samsara is very dirty and foul, that means you have no fruition in your spiritual cultivation, that you still have no power in your spiritual cultivation. That's why you feel that samsara is dirty and foul. Because in the eyes of the Mahasiddha, the whole world is clean and pure. So if you say that the samsara is dirty and stinky, that's dualistic. For the true Mahasiddha, the samsara is clean and perfect. How come it's dirty and foul? But money is the dirtiest and you love it most. Didn't you say that once you build the temple, all the Buddha statues are sparkling, luminous, beautiful, clean, and dignified with self-mastery and radiant and luminous? That's not dirty and it's not stinky, it's not smelly. Let me tell you, for the true Mahasiddha, a real high adept, when you open your eyes, it's pure land. When you close your eyes, it's a temple. When they open their eyes, it's pure land. When they close their eyes, it's a temple. For Sakyamuni Buddha, he's in meditation all his life. He's never abandoned meditation. He is totally focused on each thing. He's always in full concentration. Everything is fine. So today, I would like to tell you, the fact that X is a good thing. It's a good thing. Because next to a Mahasiddha, there will always be an X. Now you understand? X is the one to make you succeed. So you write all that she claimed to be dirty and stinky to let people know, so that people know what is allowed and what is not allowed. So my primary purpose of writing the books is to let you, to teach you what is allowed and what is disallowed. If you say truthful words, that's allowed. But untruthful words is disallowed. X often said that she often went to Maha Twin Lotus Ponds to have a meeting with Grandmaster. That her soul would travel out of her body to go to Mahadabha Lotus Pond to meet with Pama Kumara. You know, but let me tell you, all Padma Kumaras were present except X, except this one. So what she said was wrong. So there's no truth in it. It's not truthful. Because in my secluded life, X said that X traveled out of the body and went to Tahiti and saw me walking around in shorts. But was I in Tahiti? No, I was not. In Tahiti, when I live in seclusion, you couldn't find me in Tahiti. You know, I wrote that there were three islands in Tahiti. One is called the Island of Tongxing. It's actually the Tongxing building in Taiwan. The other one is the Island of Tianxi. It's also the Tianxi building in Taiwan. And the next one is the Island of Yinyue. It's where I am living now in Taiwan. It's the International Theater building. And on the island of Tianxi, there was a swimming pool in the shape of a leaf, so that's why I call it the Leaf Lake. I was not in Tahiti, and yet you claim that you traveled out of your body and saw me in Tahiti. You were always wrong. Those were lies. This karma created by speech. You cannot create such karma. You have to speak truthfully. Could you really travel out of your body? Let me tell you one important thing. Many people, many disciples from San Francisco would dream of her at night. Or sometimes during their practice, her face would appear. Why? Let me tell you. Because she employed too many ghosts, and all those ghosts transform into their her faces that would appear in your dreams, in your visualization, or in your practice. That her face will appear. It's not her. Because she cannot travel out of her body. It's made by her ghost. So by knowing that, when you see her face, I've said it before, visualize her head fall into a dung, eating the poo. Eat the poo. It's not her, it's the ghost. It's the ghost that she employed, because she had no such power to travel out of her body. She always said that she traveled out of body, but that was all wrong, all lies. So now you all know, don't lies, don't speak all the nonsense. Let's not talk about her anymore. But I like to teach you not to lie. Don't let your body create bad karma. You don't create karma with your thoughts in this life. In this life, please don't create karma. Then your life would be pure. And karma that you created from your past lives can be eradicated through your Dharma practice. So that's the Vaitara Dharma. And we want to talk about the three sense perceptions. These are all just titles. The explanations is at the back. So first the topics or the titles and then the explanations. I don't need to see the explanations, but I can talk about it. What is the three sensations, the bodily sensation? When you eat the sweet candy, you would taste the sweetness. That's the bodily sensation or perceptions. And when you see the flowers and you find the flowers beautiful, that's the mind sensation or perception. And when you see the sour plum, you would salivate. That's also the mind sensation or perception. So if you touch something smooth and white and soft, then you would feel like a what? So, like in the bus, well, there's a lady, and then when the bus kind of toppling, and then you would bump into her, and then you feel really happy, really pleased about it. That's the bodily sensation. And at first you have generated the sensation in your mind, and then when you touch her body, then you have the bodily sensation. Or in the train, that the lady was standing next to you and you were seated and you pretend to be sleeping, and then when the train moved, then you touch her leg, and then you felt, wow. So those were the pigs, like on the bus or on the train, the perverts. And for the eyes, nose, ears, tongue, body, and mind. And there's another kind of pervert that would take pictures of people's skirts. What's good is that? You can just go to the store and buy that triangular thing. And how would you feel in your heart? Why do you want to take pictures of that? That's because of the mind sensation. So the eyes see it, the ears heard it, the tongue tasted it, and the body touched it, and the mind. So that's the mind sensation and the dream sensation or perception. So in the dream you chant Amitabha and Amitabha did not show up, but your lover showed up. That's the dream sensation. But the three sensations we talked about here is not about the mundane sensation. So it's your body will become very peaceful and at ease, and your body would become tender and smooth, and you would look more dignified. And the bodily sensation, very simple. That's the bodily sensations. As long as you move the qi would show up. That you practice until your whole body is filled with qi, and that kind of sensation is different. And the sensation of wind, you would fly. You would fly in your meditation. The sensation of the earth, you would feel your body is very strong and powerful, like the mountain. That's the sensation of the earth. And then the temperature is just right, and you would always feel warm. That's the sensation of the fire. And the sensation of water is you feel that your brain is really cool and comfortable. And you feel yourself is completely pure. That's the feeling of the water. That those were all the bodily sensations. And what is the mind sensation? When you move the qi to the eye, and the eye can see the intangibles, the Buddhas, the Bodhisattvas, the Pratika Buddhas, and the Sravakas. And you can see them, and you can also see the ghost. And you close your eyes, you open your eyes, you move the qi to your eyes, then you can see. And you move your qi to the ears, then you can hear. And when you move your qi to the nose, then your smell, sense is very broad. Is this rotten? You can smell it and you know. No. With the smell, you know if it's still good and edible. That's your olfactory, that's your smell sense. You can move the qi to the hands. That's natural. That's the movement of the qi. The qi moves to the hands, and then you naturally generate such power. And you move the qi to the feet, and the feet would also have that power. And move to the eyes, then the eyes can see. Move to the ears can hear. You move to the tongue, and the sense of smell and taste will appear and very strong. And you can see the intangibles too. When the qi moves up and you move it there, and then if there's good qi in the house, then you know there are Buddhas and Bodhisattvas there, and it's bad qi, then there's ghosts. If you reach such a stage in your spiritual cultivation, then you would have power. Then you know that in the mind sensations and dream sensation, in Tantrayana, there is the dream yoga or dream practice. And how is that? That you also cultivate spiritually in your dreams. In Grandmaster's dreams, I often fly. The other day, I flew happily all over the place. I could fly in my dream. Not just flying, you can also transform. And you get whatever you want. You like that thing? You extend your hand, and that thing would fly to you. And there's a cup of water there, glass of water, and you want to drink it, and the water would fly to you in the dream. So that glass of water would fly to you. So whatever you like would appear in the dream. And when you have bad dreams, you can chant mantra. Om Mahabalaya, Om Hom Pe. And the bad stuff would disappear with Mahabala mantra. And you see Amitabha and Om Amidevase. You see Guan Yin, Bodhisattva, Om Mani Padme Hum. And whichever deity you see, you can chant his or her mantra. And when you see a bad dream is about to appear, you would chant Pe in your dream. And the bad dream will disappear, will vanish. This is called the dream sensations. The three kinds of sensations, the bodily sensations, the mind sensations, and the dream sensations. So mind includes the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, body, and mind. And the root of the mind and alaya, which is Buddha nature. They're all included in the mind. And body is the feeling on our body. And the feelings of in the dream. There are three kinds of sensations. Let me tell a joke. When I'm angry, I would throw stuff into the toilet. And today, I threw an apple. And it blocked the toilet. And asked someone to unclog it. When there was a young man that unclogged the apple. And I said, "Oh, young man, you're incredible. And you could unclog such a big apple." And he said, "Oh, but madam, you're even more incredible. You could excrete such a big thing." So the perception or the sensation of the two people are different. One felt that you could unclog and pick such a big thing from that toilet hole. And he thought that such a big thing that you could excrete it from your anus. A few days ago, I donated blood, and the person asked, "Do you have a regular sex partner?" And then they said, "Well, that in that case, you cannot donate money." And then the man said, well, but I am a virgin, so I cannot donate blood. Do you have a regular sex partner? Then you will not have AIDS, because people are afraid of AIDS in the blood donated. But that's not the case. You should just check. You should just check, have a blood test. This is not the right. This joke is not right. There are lots of things that's not right. Some things are right, some are not. For a siddha, the one with attainment, thinks that everything is the best arrangement. Grandmaster regards everything as the best arrangement. X is also the best arrangement. Because you know, I have used up all my materials. I didn't know what to write, and all of a sudden, X appeared. Oh, you know, I could write 10 books about her. I have so much inspiration. Well, maybe not that many. It would be quite sad. Enough is enough. If you can understand my books, then you would understand my heart. I really hope that she would cultivate spiritually and not create any more lies and tricks, like talking with the flies and with the mosquitoes and with the flies that's been waiting for her for 110,000 years, or earth god that's been waiting for 500 years. My gurus told me, what is an earth god? My guru taught me, what is an earth god? The so-called earth god that is enshrined at your home is a kind-hearted and virtuous member of your family that was sent to your home by the Yama King. So the earth god in your house was actually a member of your family that was kind-hearted and virtuous after he died. And what is the earth god in a village? That someone that is kind and charitable in the village, then after he died, the city god asked him to become an earth god in the village. So that's the earth god in the village, and he knows everybody in the village. And the earth god of a house is someone in your family member that was kind and good, that come to your family to protect your family. That's the earth god in a family. I was told by my guru. And the earth god in the village is the same. That's how they come about. So the earth god in a house can't possibly wait for 500 years, because he doesn't have such power. How about the fireflies waiting for you for 110,000 years? The fireflies are far lower than the earth god. And why do you have your monks and nuns carrying an earth god everywhere with them? Who was the earth god? I'd like to ask you. They were ghosts. It's not any thing else. I could see. Don't play tricks on me. How could I not know who the Earth God is? The Earth God at the house of Dharma Sister Lei in Calgary, Canada. You claim that the Earth God was waiting for 500 years to take refuge in her. And a fly flying and was about to take refuge in her. And one time there was a fly flying to my head. I didn't dare to say such things, like a fly wanting to take refuge in me. They have no such soul. Human beings, of all the living beings, human beings are best to cultivate spiritually. Animals rarely have any spiritual souls. Or the king of fish knock on the door of your motel in the middle of the night. How do they knock? With his head? With his fin? Tail? Oh God. How can it be like this? And she lost her chanting beads. But my chanting beads are very beautiful. I cannot lose it. $5 only. And she claimed that her chanting beads are running errands for her. Oh my God. Your errands, your chanting beads can run errands? How about your underwear? Please don't play such tricks to make a fool of people. You know, the elephant waiting for you for 500 years, and then Maria and all the angels at the cathedral in Dominican Republic were also waiting for you for 500 years. Oh gosh, really. What a joke. Well, for joking around, maybe okay. Grandmaster's underwear is running errand. I was just joking around. And we'll just think of you as joking. But if you're not joking, and you were serious, then that would be unforgettable. That's just... The teacher said the muscles of a human being are divided into three kinds. What are they? So if you've studied physics or chemistry, you would know. And the student, Xiaoming, was sleeping. So the guru specifically pointed to him. And Xiaoming looked at the teacher and then asked the student next to him, "What? The question?" This question is like the meat, three kinds of meat. So he said the lean meat, the fat meat, and the marble meat. That was a joke, of course. So the muscles of a human body, three kinds, what are they? Meaning the lean meat, the fat meat, and the marble meat. Do you know? Anybody down there? So, sympathetic muscles, parasympathetic muscles, and what else? Why don't you check your in the internet, your cell phone? Then you will know, because I don't know either. Actually, we studied it before. Like what he said, some muscles can move, some muscles cannot. So there are two kinds, but they're with different names. It's not moving muscles and unmoving muscles. This is all just going in tension. Actually, cardiac, smooth, and skeletal. Three types of muscle tissue: cardiac, smooth, and skeletal. It sounds like a braised soybean meat. Oh, meat, chicken, muscle sounds like chicken in Chinese. So our body have certain kinds of sensations. If you're sick, you cannot lift your arm sometimes. You cannot lift it upright. And it would be painful when you go over here because there's some problems here. And you can clutch on your ears. And also move it backward and straighten it. Oh, I know, a chicken. So the skeletal muscle and smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. Many different things about our body. So whatever posture that you can make, and some people have very long arms and they can scratch any itch on his or her back, because itch is also a bodily sensation, and you can touch anyway. And Grandmaster's arm is rather short, not very long. Some people have very long, and they can rub their back. They have no need for towels. Their hands can bend and touch the backs, and two hands can touch each other. But my arm cannot scratch the itch at my back, so that's why I place that tool on next to my bed. Because at night when it's very itchy, I couldn't. So I use that itch scratcher, and you have to be careful not to tear your skin. Because skin is protective, and if the skin is broken, that germs can get in, and there are tons of germs in the air. So the three sensations, the bodily sensations, mind sensations, and dream sensations, and everybody's sensations are different. Like Grandmaster, sometimes also think of good sensations, but Grandmaster can control what can be done, what cannot be done, what is it that's creating karma. If it is creating karma, then by all means, don't do it. You have to control yourself. But then you can do things that doesn't create bad karma. So why does Grandmaster keep writing and talking about X? Let me tell you. Because I would like to write about the truth. What I write is the truth, and at the same time, I would like to teach all of you to teach you what is allowed and what is not allowed. You cannot create a speech karma, bodily karma, and the mind karma, or karma due to your thoughts. If you take other people's money, like for Grandmaster, X actually was learning from you, from me, from Grandmaster. It's very simple. In all my life, I never opened my mouth to ask for money. You need to learn this from me. You cannot say that to be the sole sponsor of your ceremony, the cheapest is $30,000 and up to $100,000. So you set the price. And you often threaten people when they will die. You often threaten people with that. And if people don't die, then in turn you would say, oh, because I know you were about to die, so I help you by practicing so you don't die. You didn't die. And then if someone died, you would say, see how accurate I was. So you can always say something. Why do you use it to threaten people? It's a natural thing. So that's why I like to teach all of you, never tell anybody when they will die. And no matter what, everything has its own cause and effect. It doesn't matter what babies are in your womb. You should never never push people to abort anything, because by aborting, you're creating karma. So I'm teaching her and teaching everybody. So you cannot create the karma due to the body or the speech or your mind. And you cannot even create karma in your dream. That's the dream practice. Then that would be complete purity. Complete purity. You cannot create karma even in your dreams. And not even in your thoughts. And not in the speech. So body, speech, and mind should not create any karma. That's all for today. Om Mani Padme Hum. We are truly grateful to His Holiness' precious Dharma teaching. And in a moment, there would be the empowerment for White Tara. And during the empowerment, please remember to visualize White Tara, to form the mudra, and to recite the mantra. This ends the English interpretation today. Please remember to return your receivers. Thank you.
让我们以热烈的掌声感谢圣尊慈悲赐受白度魔法灌顶。在附魔殿那边有捡到一个手机，大家看一下你们的手机有没有丢掉，如果有的话去上面看一下。 观想行力，回天心三印，二拜诸菩萨，嗡啊吽观想行力，回天心三印，三拜诸护法金刚，嗡啊吽观想行力，回天心三印，四平等一起诵。护摩法会圆满即将结束了，非常感谢根本传承上师的大家持，感谢师母作为上师、法师、讲师助教与大家的护持，以及网络直播现场观看的观众，谢谢大家，功德无量，网络。